Do you find it difficult to build a rapport with your patient? Are you finding it difficult to make your role play conversational? Hi everyone, I'm Richard Caroline, an IT trainer from IILT. In this video, we are going to see how important it is to have a rapport with your patient and also going to see how we can easily develop that in your role play because it is an important criteria. While doing an IT role play, relationship building is a very important area that you need to consider to get your B grade. And it might be a Herculean task for many of the candidates as well, because sometimes we'll get too involved by getting carried over with the task explanation. So you'll be so nervous to build the relation with the patient or interact with the patient. As you know, we have two criteria for the OET roleplay. We have the linguistic criteria as well as the communicative criteria. In the linguistic criteria, they will see whether you have all the skills related to the language, such as your grammar, pronunciation, accent, your suitability of language, and many more. But when it comes to your communicative criteria, there are many areas that you need to consider because you are interacting with another person. So they are going to see whether you have the skills to start a conversation, move forward with it, and finish it in a good way. And for that, you need to have a good relation with the other person. So it is quite simple to understand that way. So let's see what are the different ways through which you can build a relationship with the patient. So basically, there are many ways you can follow. So I have picked the main five and there are many more to it. So we have discussed it in our IILT learning app, which is available for all of you and you can learn from it. The first thing you need to keep in mind in order to develop a relation with a patient is sound happy to help. Most of us are getting really focused on the task and task completion when we are doing the role plays. It is important. I'm not saying task completion is not important, but what is more important here? We are trying to understand the patient's concern and we're trying to give a solution for that, right? So you need to sound very happy, genuinely happy to help the other person. If the other person sitting across to you is not finding that connection with you, it is not going to be a good conversation. So what can you do there? So here, you need to make sure whatever you are saying is not for the sake of saying it, but you genuinely mean it. Have a small smile on your face. A small smile can bring huge difference in the way you speak. Say for example, we all know the normal way of introducing, right? We say, good morning, my name is Richa, I'm one of the registered nurses working in this field. So, was that conversational? Not at all. Because I just sounded very scripted. I was not giving any sort of intonation or I didn't show any emotion or I was not being friendly with my patient too. Instead of saying like this, what you need to do is that you can say, good morning, my name is Richa, I'm one of the registered nurses working in this emergency department. How can I help you? You see the difference there? Here, what I did is I just added a little bit of intonation. So that brought a lot of changes there. So you need to sound really happy and genuinely happy to help your patient. It will definitely build the relationship between you and the patient. Let's look into the second thing, what you need to keep in your mind while doing the OET role play in order to have a good rapport. Be very attentive and show a respectful behavior or an attitude. So you have to make sure that you are seemingly very attentive as well as you listen very carefully too, and the patient should feel like you are listening very carefully to the patient. For that, you can either nod, like, you know, you can show like, I'm listening to you, or you can use some responses by saying, okay, I understand, I see, I'll make a note of it, all right, etc. So always make sure that you are actively engaged in the conversation. When the patient is speaking, do not just sit there, look into your cue card. You can definitely look, maybe a glance, but don't spend your entire time looking into the cue card and preparing your next dialogue. Make sure that you're showing some glimpse by listening to the patient there. Also, it is very important that you seek permission before you ask questions. That is called a very respectful behavior. Do not just ask the patient any question out of the blue moon. Prepare the patient, guide the patient, give a heads up to the patient that I'm going to ask you some questions, be ready. Okay, so if you do this, you're kind of like showing a good courtesy there, so the patient will be happy to discuss things with you. So that's the second point. Now let's see what's the next point that you have to keep in mind. Avoid being judgmental. It is very important because I have seen many candidates doing or being very judgmental while doing the role play. Because especially when they ask questions like, how many cigarettes do you smoke in a day? And the patient is telling you, I smoke 20 cigarettes. I've seen responses like, oh my God, that's a huge number. Don't you know it is harmful for you? Never do that. If you're being judgmental in your OET role play, it's going to badly affect your score. Instead of saying or giving a response like, oh my God, that's too much, or giving a bad response and being judgmental there, you can say, Mr. David, I'll make a note of it. Because later in the role play, you'll be definitely giving suggestions or recommendations about how to quit smoking, right? So you don't have to sound judgmental there. Another point I have to add here is that if you're being judgmental, it's not going to help you to have a good relation with the patient. The patient will lose the trust and the patient will feel a little hesitant to share all the information to you, because we also don't like to discuss all the information to a judgmental person, right? Because we don't like judgments. So keep that in your mind. Never be judgmental. The next point you have to keep in mind is that be more benevolent and compassionate. Someone who is benevolent actually wishes really good for the other person, and being compassionate is a good way of showing the concern for the next person. So it is very important that you are being benevolent and being compassionate while you're doing the role play, because empathy is an important criteria when it comes to your OET role play, right? You need to understand what is the concern of the patient, because you're giving a solution, you're giving some recommendations, some suggestions to overcome the problem of the patient. So in order to do that, you should know what exactly the patient is going through. So you should sound really helpful as well as really compassionate while you're doing the role play. This is a good and effective way to build a relationship. So if you look into your real life scenario, we will really be comfortable to talk to someone who is being very compassionate and polite and a good listener, right? Because we'll be more comfortable and it will be more trustworthy too. So likewise, when it comes to a hospital setting, when you're doing the role play also, if the patient is, if the patient has to be more comfortable and trustworthy towards you, you need to sound very compassionate there. So it is a very effective method for you to build a relationship with the patient. The fifth point that you have to keep in mind to build a relationship is sound reassuring. Just imagine, whenever you personally go to a hospital, what do you expect in return? You expect the doctor or the nurse to come and tell you that there is nothing wrong with you, right? That's what we expect when we go to the hospital being sick. This is the same thing what the patient or the bystander expects from you when they approach you. So in all this setting, regardless of what the context is, make sure that you sound very reassuring. The patient or the bystander should get an idea, or they should feel like they have reached the right place and that everything will be all right and they are in safe hands. So make sure that you use a lot of reassuring statements like, I understand you're going through a lot, but don't worry, you have reached the right place, you are in safe of hands, we will do everything needful. So make sure that you give a lot of reassuring statements there. And from the beginning till the end, you should sound reassuring as well. Make sure that you're providing a lot of hope. Okay, so that's how you can build a good rapport with the patient, by sounding reassuring. So next time onwards, when you practice doing the role play, make sure, rather than giving a lot of importance to task completion, keep it a little more interactive with the patient to make sure that you are building a relationship there. For more informative videos like this, stay tuned to our channel.
IILT, it's my cup of tea.